So we're going to set up a single master and a single worker Kubernetes cluster. And then we're going to set up a sample app. This app will intentionally give you a 3-second latency on the requests that are sent to it. So the request, I'll try to send the request from the master node, and then we'll see the 3-second delay, and we'll try to figure out where the issue is and how to troubleshoot it. Let's jump to my VS Code. So to make things easy, I already have the cluster in place. I'm going to get the IP address of control plane. We need this, which is 172.18.0.3 is the IP address of my master node, right? So let me quickly apply. So I'm right, so my container is running. So what we have done right now is we've just set up the cluster setup. Cluster is already there. We've just set up this app pod, and now we'll try to send a request from the master server to the app pod. For that, we need the IP address of the pod. Right, so I'm going to say pod IP. So remember, pod IP is on 10 network and the master IP is on 172 network. These two IPs are really crucial. So please remember those. So I will connect to my master node. I will also connect to my master node here, because I'll have to install Tcpdump. So Tcpdump is the tool that we are going to use to troubleshoot issue here. I'm quickly setting it up. So it's already there, so just skip this step. So for now, what we can do is do a call on this request. HTTP So this is an app that simulates 3-second latency on this request. So it took 3 seconds to respond back. How can we capture the response? We can do a TCP dump -i 80 is the interface name. You can also capture the host. The host we are trying to capture packets from is the pod IP. And we can request this. Again, let's, for the sake of convenience, let's do it for 1 second. Right? In 1 second, we got a response. So you see the captured file, captured outputs here, right? So it's hard for me to analyze this from the terminal. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to capture it in a file. I'm going to bring it down to my Windows machine, and then we'll analyze what's happening, right? So now let's give a delay of 5 seconds and then see how the packets are captured. If you want, you can say -r and you can say, so these are the packets that are captured. It's hard for us to analyze here. So what we'll do is, we'll try to ship it from the container. To our local system. I don't want it here. I want it here. So what I'm going to do is docker ps. I'm going to get the container ID of my control plane. I and then I'm going to bring my package capture.pcap here. So I have this folder here. So I have Wireshark installed on my server on my Windows machine, so I should be able to capture these packets using Wireshark. So this is the important thing that you have to understand. So when we are sending a request from my master IP to the pod IP, and then it did not take much time to establish the connection, but to receive the data from 10.244, which is pod IP, to my master, which is 172.18.0.3, it took 5 seconds. So this is the time frame that it took to process this request, and the response length is 241 and the status is 200. If you are trying to curl Google instead of this google.com, you can analyze this with post sent to google.com. And I don't want to capture the file here, but I just want to show you that you can capture the packets even for a specific host when you're trying to call, right? So the packets are captured. You can save this file with a -w, and you can bring it back to your local system, and then you can analyze it.